Well, the NDP policies are destroying Alberta. And of course, everyone knows about the carbon tax. And of course, on one side of my sign, I have Stop Alberta's Job Loss, Drop the Carbon Tax, We Beg You. But on the other side, I have hospital parking rates are unfair to the sick and their families. Drop the rates at all hospitals. Yes, I have leukemia. Yesterday, I was in Calgary at a specialist. We paid $15.50 for our parking. And this is asinine. She's trying to raise money in the wrong way. Alberta Health is a fat cow that needs to be weaned down. And in all honesty, with as far as her climate change moves, I have to say that until China, Saudi Arabia, Pakistan, India, all those, and Iraq, all those countries that are creating the bulk of the emissions, they have to implement controls. Implementing a control in a province where, look at our skies. Are we overridden with pollution? No. And yet she's destroyed our oil industry. Yes, the price of oil helped, but she, with her carbon tax, is responsible for lots of changes. For instance, a cattle finishing company closed its doors after 60 years of operation. They finished over 112,000 cattle a year, and they laid off 85 people. Now, think of what that did to our ranching community. Have these farmers and ranchers not paid enough with her stupid implementation of Bill 6? We ranted, we raved, we marched about Bill 6. She didn't listen. What does it take? I don't know.
So it sounds like you sound very personally connected to a lot of these issues. Which one is it that upsets you the most?
I think the most is the fact that she fails to listen to us and her climate change policies and her alignment with Justin Trudeau has cost us immeasurably. Because she wanted to go to that environmental conference, she went, met with Trudeau, and promised something no other province was promising: to shut down coal-burning plants and to implement a carbon tax. And lo and behold, he took her to the environmental conference, the only premier that went. She's still doing the same. And what did Justin promise her in exchange? I'll give you a pipeline by the end of the year. Do you see any pipelines? No. She said, I'll give you one, possibly two pipelines. Yeah, right.
So there are deals being made that are sort of like backroom deals that we're supposed to get benefit from, and it just feels like they never come to fruition.
It doesn't happen. And all I want from Premier Notley, I'm not here to call her any names. I'm here to beg her to listen to her people. She's got to start paying attention. Look around. I mean, there's a lot of people upset. And there's a lot of my friends that wouldn't come because they're afraid. They're afraid that if they're filmed or they're seen or they sign anything, that there'll be retribution. Because, amazingly enough, even though I have leukemia, lo and behold, Revenue Canada is auditing me for my medical costs. And I cannot help but think that there's something that transfers to what I'm doing, because I've written to the Premier at least 20 times, and I've written to the Prime Minister too. Never had a response from either one of them. I've written to lots of past premiers and prime ministers. They've always responded.
Does it feel like a little bit, like this is the sense that I'm getting, if you have an illness like this and you're kind of at the end of what's bearable in terms of what you can take, does it feel like you're almost a martyr going out there for these friends that don't want to show up and don't want to be seen? Like somebody,
I understand my friend's fear.
Yeah,
I do. A lot of them have said to me, Linda, we're not going because we don't want to be filmed being there. You know, I understand it. And I'm not trying to be a martyr. I've been at all the Bill 6 meetings before I got leukemia. And I mean, I try very hard to communicate to the government that what they're doing isn't right. So, And she knows it. In her heart, she absolutely knows it. But she's not doing anything about it. Look at Justin Trudeau. He came to Medicine Hat to speak thinking he could shore up Stan Sakamoto's campaign and it'd be a winner. He walked out of the hall where he was being cheered by Liberals into a crowd of people who yelled and screamed at him. That wasn't on TV, just a little tiny bit of it. And then when the vote came in, 70% went Conservative and only 20% for Stan. And I have to tell you, Stan Sakamoto is a very fine man. But that just shows you how angry people are. They know Stan's a good man, but they weren't going to vote Liberal, not come hell or high water. So, you know, we have to do something, and this is about the only thing we can do.
Is there anything that I haven't asked you that you would have wished to have been asked, or something that you wanted to be able to say I haven't prompted you to say?
No, you've given me way more time than I ever thought you would.
Hey, as long as there's nobody starting yet, then I'm happy to interview you. Well, thank you very much for the interview.
You are more
you have
than
an excellent
welcome,
day.
And you know what I want to say?
What's that?
Thank you for being here, because newspapers, for instance, have dropped stories about the Syrian children beating up on Christian girls in schools. They've dropped stories about any unpopularity of both levels of government. Why? Because they're threatened with publish it and you'll lose your government money.
Right. I don't get any government money at all, and I run all my stuff on YouTube, so nobody can tell me what to do. We can literally tell them to fuck off.
Yeah, well, in all honesty, YouTube is probably more reliable now than our newspapers or our television. And isn't that sad?
It's really weird.
Yeah.
It's getting weird.
It is. It's getting very weird, and I don't know why the government can't listen. I don't know why a person... I know why Justin doesn't listen. He's a spoiled brat who never worked a day in his life, and he still isn't working. And when he bankrupts Canada, he'll put his family in a plane, his millions are all invested offshore, and he'll fly away. And we'll be left with a country that has a deficit that allows us to get no credit rating at all. It's just a sad 300,000 more refugees. Do you realize that a refugee family of four children and two adults gets $5,280 a month for food, because it's based on the federal food allowance that an MP gets, okay? Then we add to it rent, utilities, household goods, household furnishings, and then each person in the family gets a clothing allowance. I know this because I worked for immigration, and I also worked for welfare for many years. So I also know how long we defeat their urge to work. If you were making $11,000 a month and you looked out and saw nothing but part-time jobs at $14 an hour, would you go to work? They come back. They come back to the immigration office or to the welfare office, and they say, "Me no speak English." And so off they go. They get sent to English as a second language again.
Free education as well.
And it costs us a fortune.
Now the other thing this is what I was always told growing up, is that our population has to grow, right? Canadian population has to grow. Reason being, we have to pay the taxes that we owe because we have an ever-mounting deficit. And if we don't have enough babies, then we've got to import people from other countries. Not because we need warm bodies here, because we need taxpayers.
Do you know there's a book out right now that says why Trudeau is pushing this whole immigration of Syrians? And because by the time he goes up for re-election, they'll be Canadian citizens and they can vote. And there's an actual book published on that fact.
And so you think that the immigrants coming in are going to act as the next voting population that will vote him back in, basically?
Well, they certainly will help.
Yeah.
I mean, there's Quebec and Ontario. They'll continue to vote for him, especially Quebec. But in all honesty, the immigration population will certainly help, because they're salted all through the other constituencies. And in all honesty, this baby
Hello.
Thing.
Hello, good morning, everyone.
Absolutely.
crap.
My heart is full.
I'm sorry to cut you off, but I'm gonna film this guy too. Thanks so much for the great interview.